All right, so let's begin our Python crash course. It's going to be a series of videos. I try to keep them as short as possible, but some of them are going to be lengthy. If you have a Python programming in the background, so we can go ahead and skip that this crash course. But I highly encourage you, even if you are a professional at Python, just quickly review the notebooks that I provide on Canvas. And if you're completely beginner at Python, so I just want you to stay with me and let's go over all the steps one by one. So the first step is to how to install Python on your computer, right? So we're going to install Python with Anaconda, and Anaconda is a distribution platform of Python. It means that it includes Python and many other libraries already in it. So when you install it, all the libraries that are available on Anaconda is going to be automatically installed on your computer. I highly recommend you to install Python through Anaconda because Anaconda is super powerful. You can use R, you can use Python, and it already comes with Jupyter Notebook, Jupyter Lab, and these are the things that we're going to use for the course. So specifically, the Jupyter Lab is an IDE. It's one of the most popular IDEs out there, and it's perfect for learning and teaching exercises. So for that reason, I highly encourage you to use to install Python through Anaconda. Okay. And so in order to do that, you have to simply go to anaconda.com. And let me actually go ahead and do that. To download the Anaconda installer. Okay, so this is anaconda.com. So again, depending if you're on a Mac or the PC, then automatically will understand what's your computer. So here, just click on Get Started. So let me go back again and show you what we just did. So let's go to anaconda.com. Again, click on Get Started. And then scroll down, download Anaconda installer. And then again, if you're on OS, click on one of these things, or if you're on Windows, click on one. So my computer is a 64-bit Windows, and so I need to click on this one, right? So if yours is 32, just make sure you click on this one. If it is 64, click on most probably your computer is a 64-bit as well. So you click on the download. And then it's a bulky software, so it's gonna take a little while. And then, so while this is going to be downloaded on my computer, I'm gonna go back on slides and show you something. But I already have Anaconda installed on my computer, so I can go move forward to some steps, but I cannot click on the last part, right? Because I already have it on my computer. But I'll show you how to do that. So let's go back to slides. So at some step, it's going to ask you will get this window, right? So and by default, the first one is not tick. It's not add Anaconda to my path environment variable. So I want to go ahead and check that box. And don't worry about this red warning. It says not recommended, or you just check that box only if you know what you're doing. You're gonna assume that you know what you're doing, so don't worry about it. But it's a really important step. I want you to do that because this will enable us to access to Python and Jupyter Lab, Jupyter Notebook, and you name it through our terminal on Mac and command window on Windows, right? So if I simply go ahead and say CMD on Windows, now I can access to my Python and Jupyter Notebook or Jupyter Lab. On Mac, if you just go to terminal and then start typing Jupyter Lab, it's going to open your Jupyter Lab, right? So for that reason, I want you to when you get to this step, just make sure that you make this box checked, right? And then the rest of it's very straightforward. You just click next, 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 and then install it on your computer, okay? So now what are the packages that we're gonna use or libraries that we're gonna use in this course? So the NumPy, pandas, and scikit-learn, these are, especially the NumPys and pandas, they are you don't need to install them. They already are installed on your computer if you install the Python through Anaconda. So the NumPy is a library which is for linear algebra, and it's very fast, because it's built on some C libraries, C and C++ libraries. And NumPy is going to be used as a building block of almost all the libraries in the PyData ecosystem. So the PyData ecosystem includes Pandas, SciPy, and scikit-learn, and etc. Right? Then the other library which we're going to use is Pandas. We're going to use this library a lot. It's because it basically, when you work with data frames, we can use Pandas to deal with data frames, right? And then it's a library built on top of NumPy, so it's going to be as fast as NumPy because, again, the building block is NumPy, and it allows for fast analysis and data cleaning. Again, whenever we are working with data frame, it's easier and more efficient to work with Pandas, right? And it has some very cool built-in visualization features in it. Then the most important package or library that you're using for the course is scikit-learn. So, and by the way, if you click on, I'm going to share this slide on my GitHub repository. So when you download that, when you pull requests to that repository, it will automatically be downloaded to your computer. So if you click on any of these links, it will navigate you to the documentation of that library. So this is NumPy. The other one is Pandas. So if you look at the Pandas documentation, you know, you can look at the user guide and see, for example, what things you can do with. So, for example, if you go to plotting, so these are the things that you can do with Pandas library. Don't worry about it. You know, I have prepared 7 different notebooks for you. So I'm going to cover everything you need to know for this course and for machine learning in general. Okay. Now again, scikit-learn, this is the most popular machine learning library out there, and it's very powerful. So, you know, it has classification, regression, clustering. We're going to talk about all these things in the class, so don't worry about it at all. And actually, we're going to talk about dimensionality reduction and things like that. So when you click on any of them, you will see, for example, how we do these things in Python. So this is really, really powerful library. And it has a user guide as well. If you click on this user guide, you will see how to do that. Then if you click on install, it shows you how you can install this library on your computer. So the idea is that NumPy and Pandas automatically are installed on your computer through Anaconda, but scikit-learn is something that you have to install it manually, right? And in order to install it manually, we have to type some code in our terminal or in our command box, right? So let's say, again, if you want to see the how to install a library, the Python library, usually they have something like this installed and they help you out how to do that. For example, look at that. It says it's asking you, what is your operating system? I click on Windows and it's ask you, what is your packager? Is it pip or conda? We didn't talk about these things, but basically these are 2 different ways that you can install something on your computer. If you have installed the Python through Anaconda on your computer, you can click on conda and then type this command, conda install then /c conda, something like this on your conda command. If you don't have conda, or in general, you can do pip. So you can simply do pip install the name of a package. You know, you can do -u, U, and then scikit-learn. You have to type this thing on your computer. I'm going to show it to you how to do that, so don't worry about it. Okay, so let's finish up this slide, and we'll come back to that. So other libraries that we use is matplotlib. This is for visualization. If you're familiar with MATLAB, matplotlib is basically very close to, very similar to MATLAB. And again, you can click on it, look at the documentation. So these are the things that we can do with matplotlib. And seaborn is something very powerful. You know, if you're familiar with R programming and the ggplot2 package, seaborn is a library in Python which is very, very comparable to ggplot2. It's very powerful. So for our course, we're going to use seaborn because of its power, right? So this is, for example, the pairplot, and we're going to talk about all these things in the course. Okay, so these are the libraries, and again, in order to install any libraries, just simply need to do conda install name of the library and pip install name of the library. So that's basically it, right? And so where can I find the notebooks? So these are, I already showed you how to clone my repository to your local computer. So after you have cloned that machine learning repository to your local computer, you can go to the folder and access all these things on your folder. Again, I'm gonna show you how to do these things in more details in the class, so don't worry about it. All right, so let's go back to our Anaconda page. I think it was downloaded on my computer, so let me go to my download folder. Okay, so you will see something like this. You will see something like this, and then you double click on it and it will start. So we are installing Python through Anaconda on my computer, right? So you click next, I agree, Joe, just me. And then you put it in a folder. Make sure that you put it in a folder that you have enough space, because again, Anaconda is a super bulky program. So it needs almost 3 gigabytes of space. If I go ahead and click next, I will get an error because I already have Anaconda 3 installed on my computer. So just for the sake of argument, I'm gonna change the name to 33, but you don't need to do that, right? And then click next. So here's the part that I wanted you to make sure that both boxes are checked. So when you do that, then you press install. So I'm not gonna press install because I already have it on my computer. You press install and it's gonna take a while because this is a bulky program. It's gonna take a while. And then after you're done with the installation, let me show you what you should do. Okay, imagine you're done with the installation. Then you have to, you can go, again, if you're on Mac, you will see where's the new application. You just search for Anaconda. If you're in Windows, you click on this Windows home button and then simply type Anaconda, right? So if I do Anaconda, you will see something like Anaconda Navigator, right? So you have to click on this Anaconda Navigator. And then it's gonna take a, you see, it's gonna do all these things on your computer as well. And let me minimize everything. Okay, so this is how it's going to look like on your computer as well, right? So basically, on your computer, you most probably you will not see this message because you will get the latest version. But if you have already Anaconda installed on your computer, it says that, okay, the newer version is available. Do you want to install it now? I say, okay, no, remind me later. Okay. So this is the Anaconda Navigator environment, and as I was saying in the, on the slides, it comes with some softwares already installed. So for example, it has RStudio, RS3, and then JupyterLab. This is the one that we're going to use, and then Spider. This is a GUI for Python. I personally prefer JupyterLab, and JupyterLab is based on Notebook, and I'm going to show you and teach you what each of these things means, but for the course, we're going to use JupyterLab. You can run JupyterLab on your computer either opening the Anaconda and click on launch, or there's an easier way, so you don't need to always open the entire Anaconda system to open a JupyterLab, right? So we wanna make sure that we can save some memory on our computer, right? Let me go ahead and close this. And all right, so imagine this is your desktop, and on Windows, I want you to press Windows and do CMD command. So this is your terminal, right? So you will see the / users, / whatever your last name or the name of the computer is. Now there's a cursor. Yeah, it's waiting for you to type something, right? On Mac, of course, you're gonna open up the terminal. I think you have base / something, right? So now if I simply type JupyterLab and press JupyterLab, right? It's going to open a JupyterLab for me in my C folder. And in basically my this folder named Jahan, right? So yours is going to be different. So let me go ahead and open one JupyterLab there. Just press enter. Okay, now this is how the JupyterLab look like, right? So Again, I'm going to talk about these things in a separate video, but so this video was just for installation of the Python through Anaconda and installing this scikit-learn package on your computer as well, right? So I haven't shown you how to install a scikit-learn package yet, but basically this is a JupyterLab environment. We're going to work with this environment and talk about it a lot more in details in the next video. So if you're able to open up a JupyterLab on your computer like this, you have done it correctly, so good job. And if you get any error, just try to reach out to me or any of the TAs. We're here to help you guys. Okay, so one last thing, let's go ahead and install this scikit-learn library. All of these, the other things are already installed through Anaconda, like NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib. Seaborn is something that you have to install as well. So let's install the scikit-learn package first, and then we go to Seaborn. Okay, so if you want to install the package, do you remember what we had, what we saw here? So this is the Seaborn. Yeah, this is scikit-learn install. It says that, okay, on Windows, and if you want to do it with pip command, so this is what you need to type in your terminal, right? On Mac, this is what you need to type in your terminal. Basically, they are the same, okay? So I have a Windows, so let me go ahead and do that. So I have to open a terminal again. So Windows CMD, this is my command prompt. And now I have to simply type in whatever I see here, right? So basically say pip install space hyphen capital U and then scikit hyphen learn, then press enter. So I already have this package installed on my computer. So basically, it's gonna say that the requirements are already satisfied. So on your computer, you'll see there's going to be a progress bar, and it's gonna, depending on the speed of your computer, it's gonna take maybe a minute or two. Okay, so I already have this on my computer. If you wanna install Seaborn, so you have to do pip install Seaborn, and then press enter. Again, I already have Seaborn on my computer as well, so it says that the requirement already satisfied, right? So, guys, it is important that at this step, you make sure that the inbox is checked. Otherwise, you cannot install everything through your terminal or command window by pip or conda, okay? So, for example, if you don't, this is important, right? Now, if I do conda install Seaborn, this is exactly the same. So either pip install Seaborn or conda install Seaborn is going to do the job, do the same thing, right? And let me press enter. This is for those of you who install Python through Anaconda. If you don't have Anaconda, the conda command is not going to work on your computer. So I show you the best way to do that. So this way, now you can install, either use the pip command packager or the conda packager. And most of the libraries out there, you can use both of the packagers, but there are some libraries that it's available on pip, not available on conda, or available on conda, not available on pip, okay? So that's pretty much it. So let's see. This is the one which is already running. This is the one. Yeah, it's good. So from conda, it's collecting some information. At the end of the day, it's going to say that all the requirements are already satisfied. I personally prefer to install packages through using a pip packager because that's more comprehensive. Okay. Automatically, it's going to give me some alternative. If you see something like this, failed with initial frozen salt, it will give you some alternative. You press Y and enter, and then it should be good to go on your computer. But if you do it through pip install, you won't get these error messages as well. It's not error, it's warning. All right, so let me see. Okay, it's already 20 minutes, so let's stop the first video. I hope that you were able to install Python and you were able to open a JupyterLab on your computer. See you in the next one.